Who is your wife?
Right back there. Excellent. Let's pray. Would you pray with me? Jesus, we surrender to you.
主啊, 我们把自己交托给你。
I surrender to you.
我把让我自己降服于你。
I have nothing to offer in myself.
我靠我自己没有什么可以给你的。
I need you.
我需要你。
We thank you that you are Lord and Master over all things.
我们感谢你, 你是我们的主, 我们的神。
We thank you that you speak through your servants.
谢谢你可以借着你的仆人来说话。
And we ask that your word would come forth today.
我们希望你的话语今天能够被传扬出来。
Whatever you want to say.
你想说什么请说。
Help me to be open and to hear from you.
让Dr. Samuel 能够听见你的话, 能够传讲。
And not to be afraid even to say hard things.
如果要讲到很难听的话的时候, 但也能够很有勇气的说出来。
In Jesus' name we pray.
奉主的名祷告。
Amen.
Amen.
So I was able to speak with some of you a little bit last time I was here about my background.
上次我在这里的时候, 我跟大家介绍了一下我的背景。
I was a pastor of English ministries for about 4.5 years at a Chinese American church in the Chicago area.
以前呢，我的背景就是在芝加哥那个地方当了4年半的，在中国教会里头一个年轻人的牧师。
One of my former students, Michael Zhang, is here with us.
我之前的一个学生 Michael就在这里。
Michael is just finishing a year-long internship with our ministry.
他这一年在我们这里当他的这个 intern.
And it's been a great blessing.
他得到很大的祝福。
So I'm not an expert in Chinese culture.
我对中国文化并不是这么了解。
But I have had more exposure than the average American.
但是我可能比一般的美国人还稍微了解多一点。
And there's a lot that the Lord has put on my heart.
有很多东西神放在我的心里面。
For my Chinese family members.
为我这个讲中文的太太家庭。
And my Chinese brothers and sisters.
还有我的，还有就是我周围讲中文的这些弟兄姐妹们。
I want to start with it, just a tiny story.
我想跟你分享一个小故事。
There's one time, early when I was a pastor at the Chinese church.
当我早期在中国教会服事的时候。
Where I was speaking with one of my students.
我跟我一个学生讲话。
The youth group and young adult group had finished.
年轻的这个聚会，还有成人的聚会也结束了。
We're standing in the kitchen.
我们在这个教堂里的这个厨房里面，我们在讲话。有一个年轻人刚结束他的大学的这个学业。大概就是七八月的时候。
那他就这个牧师就问他说，你毕业后你现在想做什么呢？ He said, I'm not really sure.
他说我不确定。
And I said, have you ever thought about ministry, some kind of Christian ministry, or maybe even working for a nonprofit organization, something more gospel focused than like what you've done in the past?
那个牧师就跟他说，你有没有想过啊，要去当一个就是 involve 在这种有关神的事工方面。 或者是读一些神的God ministry, right?
Yeah.
就是以神为中心的一些这个事工。
Yeah, good. And he looked at me and kind of shook his head and like, no, pastor.
然后呢，他就摇头就说不，我不想要。
I'm like, no, why? Like, what's holding you back? Why wouldn't you consider?
牧师就问他说，为什么呢？你不想，为什么你不考虑呢？
He said, Pastor Sam, I have had a lot of help from my
他说我从我的父母亲那里得到很多的帮助。
They paid for my college.
他们付我的学费。
Now I have to get a good job.
我现在必须要一份好的工作。
Make lots of money.
要赚很多钱。 然后还给我的父母亲。
Amen. There's no way.
所以我没有办法去做有关神的这个事工。
And the conversation sort of stuck with me.
那这个话一直在我心里面，我就在想。
In my head.
在我的头脑里面。
And as I continue to do ministry in the Chinese church, and especially as I was working with these young people, I was really encouraging them to live their lives for God, to give everything they could to the Lord.
对，当我是在这些中国人的这个教会服事，而且服事这些年轻人的时候，我就其实很希望鼓励这些年轻人能够来服事神。
But I kept feeling like I was running into a brick wall.
但是呢，他总觉得好像碰壁一样。
And there were these certain expectations.
有某些的期待。
And there were these certain trajectories, paths that they were all expected to follow.
就这些孩子们，有一些人对他们一些期待，有一些路呢是希望那个孩子们要走的。
I want to talk to you today about a difficult topic.
我跟你今天讲一个不容易分享的一个题目。
I want to talk to you today about the topic of idolatry.
我跟你讲一个就是有关这个偶像。
拜偶像的事。 What is idolatry?
什么是偶像？
Idolatry is when anything beside God, besides God, becomes like God.
就是它不是神，但是像神的东西。
It's when something becomes first place in your life.
就是有些东西成为你生命中。
Often the most dangerous idols are actually good things. Things like a good job, or our family, or financial security. Good things can be the most dangerous idols. Idols can be very subtle.
偶像可以很真实的。
Where you almost don't even know that you're
worshiping. 甚至你可能都不知道你正在那个敬拜他。
In the Old Testament, in the old days,
在旧约的时候,
people used to have images like carved statues.
他们那个时候是用看得见的那个偶像在敬拜。
In many places in the world, people still worship these statues.
在世界里头也有很多人都是用看得见的偶像在敬拜。
Or a god that they represent.
Yeah, 就是长得像他们所拜的那个神。
Most of us probably don't have these images.
大部分的好像可能没有像。
If you do, you should not have those images.
假如你有的话，你应该不要有那些偶像的像。
But even if we don't have an image that we worship.
即使我们没有那些看得见的那个像在敬拜。
Our worship, our first priority can be pulled away.
我们的，但是我们的那个心中的守卫可能还是被那些东西给带领的。我们可能就是祭拜那些看不见的那些偶像。So
here's the question I want to ask today.
今天我想问一个问题。How
do we find freedom from idolatry?
我们怎么样从这个拜偶像中能够释放出来？How
do we find freedom from idolatry?
我们怎么样从这个敬拜偶像中释放出来？
Especially idolatry that has been passed down from generation to generation to generation.
特别是那些敬拜偶像从我们的祖宗那边一代一代传下来的这些东西。
The most dangerous idols, I believe, are good things.
我相信那些东西很多都是好的东西。
And the most dangerous idols are the idols that we have inherited.
而且那些好东西可能都是我们从我们的祖宗那边遗传过来的。
The idols of
就是我们的父亲的，我们父亲所拜的那些东西，可能成为我们的偶像。
The Bible speaks explicitly that we are to worship God alone.
圣经告诉我们说，我们应该只敬拜那位真神。
There is no one beside.
因为没有任何一位神呢。
It's the first of the Ten Commandments, right? You shall have no other gods before me. Make no graven images. It's right there from the very beginning.
就是圣经的前两页，没有其他的神，只有一位真神。
We see this repeated in the Bible over and over again, from Genesis to Revelation.
我们从圣经整本都可以看到这个所强调的。
But God's people always struggle with worshiping idols.
但是神的百姓总是一直在挣扎，在要敬拜别的神。
So how do we find freedom? From idols. How do I find freedom from my inherited idols? So I can freely follow Jesus. We're going to start to answer that question by opening your Bibles to Judges chapter 6. Judges chapter 6. And we're going to pray short, really, real briefly as we open the Bible. Lord, thank you for your word. Your word is holy. We receive and we believe your word. We choose to focus ourselves for this short time on your truth.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
In Judges chapter 6, the people of Israel are under oppression.
就是四世纪第六章讲到以色列人在压制下。
Israel has disobeyed the Lord.
以色列人违背了神。
They still kind of worship the Lord.
他们还是在敬拜神,
but they just also worship idols.
但是他们还也敬拜偶像。
Sadly, a lot of Christians
很突然有很多的基督徒
worship the Lord.
他们敬拜神,
but they've got a few other little gods with them.
他们也有一些小神, 这个在跟着他们。
Israel has turned away from God mainly. They still call him their Lord, but they're worshiping idols. And they're being oppressed. They're under the control of the Midianites. Often the Midianites would come in and raid Israel and steal their possessions. Israel could never get ahead. They were very poor. They were always afraid. And the Lord says that he's not going to continue to bless them in their sinfulness. But in verse 11, the angel of the Lord pays a visit to a man named Gideon. Says this in verse 12.
我们看第十二节。
The angel of the Lord appeared to him and said to him, "The Lord is with you, O valiant warrior." And Gideon said, "Oh my Lord, if the Lord is with us, why has all this happened to us? And where are all his miracles which our fathers told us about?"
He says, "Did not the Lord bring us up out of Egypt?"
But now the Lord has abandoned us and given us into the hands of Midian. But the Lord looked at him and said, "Go in your strength and deliver Israel from the hand of Midian. Have I not sent you?"
耶和华观看基甸说：“你靠着你这能力从米甸人手里拯救以色列人，不是我差遣你去的吗？”
Gideon is an obscure man, an unimportant man.
Gideon
呢, he says he's the least in his tribe and even in his family group.
他说呢, 他是在他父家中是自微小的, 而且是很贫穷的。
But God had a great destiny for Gideon.
但是呢, 上帝对他有一个特别的心意。
God wanted to use
Gideon. 神想要使用基甸。
Gideon didn't feel like he was supposed to
be. 基甸觉得他自己不配被神使用。 但是上帝对他有一个不同的计划。
And Gideon and his family, like the rest of Israel, kind of worshiped the Lord, but they also had other idols.
对，我们刚才提就是以色列人，他们一方面敬拜神，但是也有别的偶像。
So the angel appears to Gideon and gives him this great mission. He says, "Go and defeat the Midianites." And Gideon's unsure, but sort of says yes.
然后那个，所以耶和华的使者就向基甸显现，然后基甸呢就害怕，他不太确定，但是他好像说 OK。
He's starting to believe it's possible. And if you remember the story of Gideon, you probably remember this kind of strange battle where they get the torches and the pitchers and they blow the trumpets and they have this huge victory, right? But I want to focus on this preliminary mission that God has Gideon to do. And often we sort of skim over it in the big story. The angel appears to Gideon and commissions him to go save Israel. But before Gideon begins his big mission, he has a small one to fulfill. As the angel leaves, Gideon realizes this really is God.
然后让基甸知道说这个是真神。
So he's planning to obey the Lord.
然后这样基甸可以顺服神。
But it says this in verse 25.
我们看一下第25节。
Now on that same night, the Lord said to him, "Take your father's bowl and a second bowl, 7 years old, and pull down the altar of Baal, which belongs to your father, and cut down the Asherah that is beside it."
当那夜耶和华吩咐基甸说，你取你父亲的牛来，就是那七岁的第二只牛，并拆毁你父亲为巴利所筑的坛，砍下旁边的木偶。
And build an altar to the Lord your God on top of this stronghold in an orderly manner, and take a second bull and offer a burnt offering with the wood of the Asherah which you have cut down.
在这个磐石上整整齐齐地为耶和华你的神筑一座坛，将第二只牛献为燔祭，用你所砍下的木做柴。
How do we get free from idolatry?
我们怎么样从那个拜偶像中释放出来呢？
I want to share with you four steps.
我跟你share四个步骤。
To freedom from idolatry.
从那个敬拜偶像中释放出来。Number
one.
第一个。
Identify your idols.
认清你的偶像是什么?
Identify your idols.
认清你的偶像是什么?
For Gideon, it was pretty easy because the Lord just showed up and said, Hey, Baal and Asherah, gotta go.
对，对今天来讲，很明显就是那个巴利所筑的坛。
But for us, sometimes it's a little harder.
但是对我们来讲，可能没有那么容易。
You don't have the altar of Baal in your backyard. Hopefully.
你可能没有那个巴利所筑的坛在你的后院。
But maybe there are things that you've been worshiping in your heart.
但是有一些东西可能是在你心里面一直在敬拜的。
Things that sometimes have ultimate significance.
有些东西没有这么明显的。
And they have to be identified.
那些东西必须把它找出来。
You have to realize it.
你必须要意识到有这个事情。
We as Christians have to think deep thoughts.
我们基督总是要想得很深。
We have to pray deep prayers.
我们必须有一个很深的祷告。
We have to think about our lives and our motivation.
我们一想想我们的生活，还要我们想到我们的这个我们的动机。
Some people live their whole lives without really asking, what is my purpose? Why am I doing these things?
有些基督徒就一直就活着一辈子，可是他从来都不知道说为什么我要这么做，我的目标到底是什么。
God has called us to follow him.
神呼召我们要去跟随他。
To obey him.
去顺服他。
To be his servants.
去成为他的这个, 仆人。
And slaves and children.
还有他的孩子。
And to do everything that he desires for our lives. We were created for God's glory.
然后能够成为他想要我们做的这些事情。
Is that the reason that you live your life?
这是我们生命的这个呼召吗?
Is that the reason you work the jobs that you work?
这也是你工作的一个目的吗?
Is that the reason maybe many of you came to the United States?
这个是你到美国来的目的吗?
Because you want to glorify.
你到美国来是不是因为要荣耀神呢?
Is there something else? What are your idols?
你的偶像是什么呢?
What is leading your life?
什么东西是主导你的生活呢?
What or who are making your decisions?
谁来做你的这个决定的主呢?
Why do you really do the things that you do?
你为什么你要做这些事情?
I want to follow God alone.
我想单单的跟随神。
I want my heart to be pure and I want to be sure that I'm doing what the Lord tells me.
我想要过得很圣洁的生活，我就想单单的顺服神要我所做的事情。
I'm gonna wake up every morning and say, God, my life is yours.
我就想早上能够起来的时候，我就跟神说，神啊，这一天是属于你的，你要我做什么呢？
And not allow myself to be controlled by other things.
那不让我自己被其他的声音所抓住了。
Who was the idol Baal?
谁是这个巴利呢？
You see this idol all over scripture. Right?
你看到这个巴利在经文中到处出现。
It's like the most popular false god.
好像就在旧约里头，它是一个很受欢迎的一个偶像。
That term Baal actually meant master or owner or lord.
巴利的意思就是主的，就是一个主的意思。
And there were actually many different deities that could be some that were called Baal.
也有很多其他的名称来称作这个巴利。
In some places in the Hebrew it says the Baalim or the Baals.
这希伯来文还有别的字来取代这个巴利的。
But in general, Baal was a god of fertility.
一般来讲巴利就是指那个跟生产、生殖有关系的。
And people worshipped Baal because they believed that Baal would give them success.
一般人相信巴利就是因为巴利会带给他们成功。
They particularly believe that Baal was in control of good harvest.
而且巴利能够带给他们好的收成,
of rain,
下雨, crops, 或者是农作物的生产。
And the people are struggling.
现在人们在这边挣扎。
And so they worship Baal, hoping that Baal would help them and bless them and give them good things.
因为他们一般拜巴利就是希望巴利能够给他们一个好的农作物的生产。 那我们现在在敬拜谁呢? 你为什么要敬拜他呢?
If I could summarize who the idol that I think many of us worship,
如果我开试着看看能不能总结一下我们现在所敬拜的这些偶像。
And maybe if I could be really bold right now.
也许我现在很胆子很大。
And see the idol that I think many of my Chinese brothers
and sisters. 还有想想可能现在大部分中国人都会崇拜的。
Maybe if I could use one word, I would say success.
成功。 成功是我们中国人所最崇拜的。
Success.
成功。
And you see it as good career.
我们以成功就是用一个好的职业来代表成功。
Good money.
有好的收入,
good family,
还有就是好的家庭,
good career, good money,
工作, 还有那个家庭, 还有就是钱, 金钱。
And often it's something that has been passed down from our fathers.
我们这些可能也是从我们的父亲那一辈传过来的,
and the pressure of our grandparents.
或者是从这个我们的祖父那边传过来的, 压力的。
Whose shrine was this? Whose altar was this?
那谁是这个巴利手足的坛呢? 圣经这边所讲的。
In verse 25, it says, go and take your father's bull and cut down the altar which belongs to your father.
在圣经说要拆毁你父亲为巴利手足的坛。
You see, there was a descending idolatry in Gideon's life.
这边讲是你父亲，所以他是一种遗传下来的。
But God had a destiny for Gideon. God had a plan for Gideon that had to be different from his family. He would free Israel. He would do something great for the name of God. But before Gideon could go and free Israel, before he could do the big mission, he had to get free in his heart. And he had to cut down the false gods. And he had to follow God. You can be used by God most greatly when your heart is given most completely. You can be used by God most greatly when your heart is fully surrendered.
Yeah, 当我们的完全对神降服的时候，是神最能使用我们的时候。
God is your one true God.
因为神是唯一独一的真神。
And I think so many of us get caught up in worshiping Baal.
但是我们很多人就被巴利这个神所抓住了。
Worshiping success.
然后来敬拜这个成功。
That can come out of a sense of poverty.
因为我们可能从那个贫穷中出来。
So many of the Chinese adults in my church had this kind of coming up from poverty story.
因为很多我们以前都是从那个贫穷中出来的。
And they were like, I was born in Western China.
我从古代西，从中国的西方长大。
And I had nothing.
我什么都没有。
And I worked so hard. And I got into this college. And I came to the U.S. for grad school. And I got this good job. And it's all been wonderful. And then they would look at their children. And they would say, what are you going to do? How hard are you going to work? What are you going to become? If I became this professor out of nothing, what can you do being born in America with everything? And there's this one thing that was pressed into their heart, pressed into their heart, pressed into their heart. Success. The Baal of success. Brother and sister, who are we really worshiping? A lot of times we become Christians and it's like we continue to worship something else.
我们有时候成为基督，可是我们事实上我们还在敬拜别的东西。
A lot of people become Christians because they think it'll help them be more.
有些人变成基督，所以说啊，基督可以让我们变得更有道德一点。
Or because it's a nice thing in America.
可能也是因为在美国这个环境比较好。 Or
because you have the freedom to be a Christian.
或者是我们在这里有自由，可以选我们要信的我们的信仰。But
being a Christian really isn't about expressing our freedom or about being more moral or about this nice community group we can have.
所以成为一个基督徒不是在于说是在于我们可以选，我们有自由可以选啊，或者是能够在这个比较好的环境里头，不是我们单单成为基督徒的目的。
It's about God being our Lord.
是因为是要神成为我们生命中的主。
It's about us realizing that He is first.
能够体会到上帝是唯一的。
He is King. He is all that matters.
他是第一个，他是神， 他是王。
And receiving union with Him through His Son Jesus and the blood that was shed on the cross.
借着耶稣基督，我们跟神能够联合。
But what are you really worshiping?
那我们真的在敬拜什么呢？
You can identify your idols by your story, by your choices, by what's in your head, by what controls you.
那你们可以想一想我们的这个偶像有什么，借着想要什么东西控制着我们的生活，在我们的生命当中。
Whatever you find in those places is your idol.
你找到的那个就大概就是你的偶像。
And one of the biggest ones is this idea of success.
我想最大的一个就是这个有关这个成功的这个想法。
So one, you have to identify your idols.
所以第一件事情，你要确认你的偶像是什么。
Two.
第二个。
You have to destroy your idols.
你要把这个偶像拆除。
Look at verse 27.
我们看第27节。
Then Gideon took 10 men of his servants and did as the Lord had spoken to him. And because he was too afraid of his father's household and the men of the city to do it by day, he did it by night.
基甸就从他仆人中挑选十个人，照着耶和华吩咐他行。他因为怕富家和本穷的人不敢在白昼行这事，就在夜间行的。
He was afraid to do it, so he took some men with him.
所以他又不敢做，所以找一些人来陪着他。
Right. Well, he needed help probably physically, so he took these men with him.
所以他找人来帮助他。
How many did he take?
Ten.
Ten, a small group of people.
他找十个人来帮助他，一个小群。
Kind of like the small group that is here. Or the small group that meets in my home. Or the small group of 12 people that follow Jesus around. But together they destroyed that idol. And they were afraid to do it in the day. So they did it at night. But when they were finished, the altar was destroyed.
对，成为一个澄清了。白天的时候呢，就他们在晚上做这事，然后白天的时候，这些塔就被拆毁了。
The Asherah idol was cut down and burned.
那些偶像被砍下，而且被烧了。
And I believe Gideon's heart was changed forever.
那我想这时候基甸的心应该是被改变。
What does it look like to destroy your idols, my idols?
那我们如果生命中的偶像被拆毁，会是个什么样子呢？
It means a change in our heart. It means a destruction in my heart where that thing no longer has control. It no longer receives my worship. It no longer receives my energy. How can I better myself towards success? I wake up every day and I say, how can I serve you, Lord? What do you want from me? There has to be this like cutting down, this immediate break, this change in my heart where I pronounce death over that idol, where I say, no more.
跟他砍断说,
there's a change in my heart. There's a destruction, a shift, a breakdown in my heart.
就是把我的这个心给,
and then there's the practice of protecting my heart.
然后呢,
brother and sister, if you are seeking success, if you are controlled by success or the expectations of your family for success, that has to go.
如果我们的生命是被这个成功所控制，或者是被着我们家庭对我们的期待所控制的话，那些东西应该要离开我们。It
has to stop.
必须要停止。It
is a destructive idol.
这就是那些毁灭我们生命的那些，因为那些这些偶像必须被拆毁。Only
God is Lord.
只有神，只有这位真神，是耶和华是真神。And
there has to come a point in your life.
这些必在我们生命中必须要面对这个事情。Where
you stop.
在那里停下来,
and you say no more.
而且你说, no more, 不再有了,
this is the end.
就这样子的,
I will serve God.
我要服侍神,
and however God wants your life to look, that has to be okay.
然后神希望我的生命成为什么样子,
I have a Korean friend who was a over a team of computer programmers at SAP. He was very, very successful. He's very smart. He went to Bible school, but he taught himself computer programming. And in 2017, the Lord spoke to him.
2017年上帝跟他说话，他说：“你把你的工作放下，我要你成为一个牧者，来跟随我。”
He said, "No, Lord."
然后当然他本来就是不主。 他就跟神，他跟神争执，有一阵子，说我不想要。 他的太太最后离开他。
He obeyed God.
当他顺服神的时候，他太太离开他。
And he let go of that job.
然后他把这个工作就放下。
And he followed God.
然后他跟随神。
And it was very scary. It was very frightening, very scary. And it was difficult. But God has provided for all of his needs.
He has so much peace.
He's so much
freedom. He
knows that that is what God is calling. Not all of you have to leave your jobs and become pastors. But maybe if you were following God more than success, there are big things in your life that would change.
Yeah,
maybe God is calling for a deeper surrender in your heart. Which produces a deeper surrender for your life.
Yeah, 然后就是更多的对我们, 就很多我们在生命中东西要放弃。
One, identify your idol.
第一个就是, 认清你的偶像是什么。
Two, destroy your idol.
好，第二个就是要把它拆毁。
Three,
第三个,
build God's altar.
建立神的祭坛。
It says, on top of the altar of Baal, in verse 26, it says, and build an altar to the Lord your God on top of this stronghold in an orderly manner, and take a second bull and offer the burnt offering with the wood of the Asherah pole, which you shall cut down.
在这磐石上整整齐齐地为耶和华你的神筑一座坛，将第二只牛献为燔祭，用你砍下的木偶做柴。
So he built a new altar to the Lord.
所以他建立了一个新的坛。
And he actually, so there was a Baal altar, and there was an Asherah pole, probably like a tall wooden pole.
所以这里有一个, 这个偶像, 然后这个有个, 木偶在这里，一个坛呢，一个坛在这，然后呢，还有啥？这个 pole， 这个
木桩哦，木桩哦。And Gideon takes what was used to worship evil.
哦，那个基甸以前用拿这个木桩呢，在拜偶像。And
he cuts it apart.
他把它切成块。And
uses it for fuel.
然后把它当做柴。To
make a sacrifice to God.
把它当做柴烧了，然后献给神。He
builds the altar of God.
他 筑了一座神的坛,
and he takes the old thing of his family.
他把那些旧的东西,
and he sacrifices it to.
他把那些东西都牺牲掉，都放下了，然后把它献给神.
You have to identify your idol. You have to destroy your idol.
你必须要找出你的偶像是什么，要把这个偶像给除掉.
And you have to build God's altar.
你必须要建立神的这个祭坛, 筑一座神的坛.
Often that will look like creating a new practice and using even what you have received for God's
good. 那意思就是你有时候要有一些新的东西, 就是你以前想过要怎么样来给神的。
Build an altar to
God. 就是建筑一个神的坛。
Build that practice in your life where God comes first and is only the Lord.
当神的事情来到的时候, 我们总是想神第一优先。
There's no other idols, there's no other altars, I'm just going to find.
没有其他的东西, 就是单单就是神。
You pass that on.
然后你把这个想法一直的,
you pass following Jesus on
to your church. 你把这个想法也传给你的下一代。 不是你的偶像。
This is going to be very hard.
这不容易啊。
That's going to be very dangerous.
也蛮危险的。
After this, the whole town comes against Gideon.
然后你看整个town，这次之后，整个town都反对这个基甸。
The whole culture revolts.
整个的文化都反对他。
And they say, who did this? Who tore down the altar of Baals? And they say, it's Joash's son, Gideon. Bring him out so we can kill him. And his father actually stands up for him. And says, let Baal defend himself. But it was really God who was protecting Gideon. Gideon did not die. But as you walk through this process of freedom, you must realize that there will be
threats.
And there will be pain.
也会有痛苦.
You see, your family doesn't really care if you become Christian.
你的家里可能不你成为一个基督徒，你的家人可能OK。
As long as you continue to be a success.
只要你能够继续成功的话，你的家人可能都OK。
If you want to go to your little church group, that's fine.
你还是去你那个小教会，你的家里OK。
It's really weird. We don't believe it.
这个信仰有点奇怪，我们不相信。
But just stay in school.
但是你还是要好好上学。
If you want to go to your little church group, it's fine, but just keep your job.
假如你要去别的地方，别的地方可以，但是你还要还是要维持这个工作。
Just make that money.
还是要记得要赚好,
just give,
有好的收入。
Just give big Hong Baos at Chinese New Year.
还是要拿到很大的红包。
But when your life changes,
当我们生命改变的时候,
when you make less money,
也许你可能赚着少了,
when you might not have that good position,
但也许你的工作职位没有那么高,
when you go into ministry,
也许你当你去做神的这个事工的时候,
they might just try and kill you.
有些人可能想要杀你，你的亲人可能想要杀你。
There are consequences for truly following the Lord.
这就是有时候跟随神的这个一个代价。
But when Gideon followed the Lord,
但是当我们从基甸看基甸跟随神的时候,
he saved his entire nation.
他却把他整个家族都拯救了。
And God could use Gideon,
所以神能使用基甸,
for true success.
给他一个真实的一个成功。
Who knows what true success is?
谁知道真实的成功是什么呢?
Does your culture or your parents know what true success is?
我们的文化，我们的亲人知道什么是真的真正的成功吗?
Who controls who is a success and who is not a success?
不是谁真的能控制真的成功呢?
True success is in God's hands.
真正的成功是在上帝的手中。
To inform it, to tell us what it really is.
他会告诉我们什么是真正的成功。
And to give whatever blessing he wants in our lives.
而且他会给我们真正就是那个真正成功所带下的祝福。
What is more successful?
什么是更成功呢?
To create a new company?
是建立一个新公司吗?
Or to lead one person to Jesus?
还是去就是带一个人信耶稣呢?
What is more successful?
什么是比较成功呢?
To be the CEO?
是成为一个公司的CEO呢?
To be a professor?
还成为一个教授?
Or to work a low-level job, but lead a Bible study. To be more impressive than your neighbor. Or to love your neighbor. Jesus' ways are different. Identify your idol. 要找出来我们的偶像是什么，把这个偶像给拆毁了，建立神的祭坛，然后最后就是圣洁。这个故事结尾是令人悲哀的。看士师记第八章第七节。Gideon was faithful to the Lord.
基甸对神很忠心,
he led his people to victory over the Midianites.
他也带领百姓胜过了米甸人,
he trusted God to give them victory with his tiny army.
他只带了一小队的兵队, 但是他却能够胜过整个米甸人。
It was all incredible. It was God's success. It was God's
plan. 这是个神迹, 是神的计划, 神的神所成就的。
But in the end, this
happened. 但是在结尾这个地方呢,
they had finished the battle and they had all this wealth and they had all the spoil. Gideon asked everyone to give one of the earrings that they took.
当他们经过这些成功之后呢，基甸却说：“你把你们的这耳环呢拿下来。”
And they gave all these gold earrings. And they made an ephod out of the earrings. Like a vest, maybe you could say. It's in verse 27.
Chapter 8, verse 27.
So they made this gold ephod, which was maybe like a vest or a priestly garment. And it says this, and all Israel played the harlot with it there, so that it became a snare to Gideon and his household.
This ephod that Gideon had made.
这个以弗德, became an idol. And Israel worshipped it.
那以色列又去敬拜这个以弗德。
How sad.
这是多悲哀的一个故事。
That in the beginning he destroyed his father's idols.
所以刚开始的时候他把他那个偶像拆毁了，他爸爸的偶像。
And in the end he created an idol that his children worshipped.
但是他在结尾的时候却制造了一个偶像，是让他的孩子去敬拜的。
So number four is stay pure.
所以第四个就是我们应该为圣洁。
Protect your heart.
要保守我们的心。
Because you can go back to the idols that you once destroyed.
你可能回去你的。 你可能回到以前你所拆毁的那个偶像，你又把它拿回来了。
Being free from idolatry isn't just a moment.
所以我们要脱离这些敬拜偶像，不是只是一时而已。
It's not a one-time decision.
也不是只是一刻而已，它是要一直让我们心保持圣洁，就只有神，只有上帝。
And sometimes you can end up making different idols.
有时候你可能会制造不同的偶像。
My wife challenges me sometimes.
我的太太有时候跟我挑战。
And she says, is ministry an idol for you?
你的事工是不是你的偶像呢?
Sometimes even the best things or the most spiritual things, even they can become idols. This was a priest's outfit. It was something that was supposed to be holy, probably. This was meant maybe for some kind of good in Gideon's mind.
有些东西可能在我们的属灵中可能也会成为我们的偶像。
But even that thing became.
那些东西
And I have to guard my heart.
我们必须要保守我们的心。
Because I have a certain picture of ministry success.
我在我的脑海里有对于这个聚会有一些意象。
A big church.
他有想说我要一个大的教会。
Or all these people listening.
还有所有的人都听话。
Or all these speaking opportunities.
还有很多讲道的机会。
But those things can become idols.
那些东西都有可能成为我的偶像。
And they fight for my heart.
在我里面我在挣扎。
And I have to continually say just you.
我必须一直跟神说神啊，只有你，只有你。
Whatever you want.
你要什么?
I'll be small, I'll speak with a few people.
对啊，我是很微小的，我就愿意对几个人传讲。
I'll just pray with you quietly.
我就是很安静的向你祷告，只有你。
Identify.
找出我们的这个偶像。 来拆毁我们的偶像。 建立神的祭坛。 然后我们要常常保持圣洁。 不要回到那个旧的偶像去。 也不要制造新的这个偶像。 这样就叫我们的心单单的归向神。
Let's close now.
那我们结束。
This is what I want to do.
这是我想要做的。
Let's just close our eyes.
我们闭上我们的眼睛。
Let's examine our hearts.
我们来审查我们的内心。
Sometimes you don't identify your idols very well.
有时候我们没有办法找出我们的偶像。
The Holy Spirit identifies idols very well.
但圣灵可以帮助我们。
So let's just pray now and just ask the Lord to do the first step.
那我们恳求圣灵来帮助我们能够来走第一步。
Lord, we know that you are a jealous God.
主啊，我们知道你是位嫉妒的神。
We know that you made us for yourself.
你创造我们是为着你自己的荣耀。 我们是你的。
But Lord, our hearts have sometimes gone astray.
有时候，但是我们心常常会偏于邪。 有些东西就在我们心中挣扎。
Lord, what a powerful people.
假如我们全然的相信你，我们知道我们会变得很有能力。What
great things we can
do. 我们可以在你的名里面，我们可以做大事。Nations
we can save.
一个整个甚至整个国家，我们可以拯救。Father, set us free from idols. 主啊，求你好分别我们，救我们脱离偶像。 我现在就祷告圣灵。 你能够显明我们心中的偶像是什么？ 把它显明出来，现在。谢谢你。
Lord, we renounce our idols. We repent of our idols. We will not worship success. And if you need to say that to the Lord, why don't you say that? I reject success.
如果你这也是你心里所说，你也可以这么说，说我拒绝这个成功。
I reject that idol.
我拒绝那个偶像。
I reject the family line of idolatry.
我拒绝那个从家庭来跟家以前从家庭那个遗传出来的那种偶像。我只单单的敬拜你，我要敬拜你。父啊，父神啊，是啊，释放我们，把你神的祭坛建立在我们的心里，让我们的心一直保存着圣洁。 让我们能够一直走这个正路，让我们完全的降服于你。为弟兄姐妹献上感谢。我们能够把你的话藏在心里，然后能够改变我们的生命。我们把自己顺服降服于你。谢谢你主，奉主的名祷告，阿门。
Well, unfortunately, I am one of those who came from the West in China. And we joined college in the US. Anyway, so, 非常好的信息，然后我也觉得很多的感动。 因为讲到了很多的地方，确实也是我自己的时常会遇到的问题。因为我们每一个人心中都有自己的偶像，就像我们今天讲的这个个人的成功，可能对于我们很多的中国人来到美国的中国人，大家来到这片土地，很大的原因就是在这里面能够实现。OK。 很大原因就是来到这里，我们可以实现自己的价值，实现自己价值就是成功。
Okay, yeah, we're just Chinese. We immigrate here, and a lot of times that we want to have success. Yeah, we do put a success in our value first.
所以呢？以后你搞不了当牧师，我们要搬。所以今天听完我们这个 Pastor Samuel 这个。 讲到之后，我觉得我们确实是应该省察自己内心。After
I hear this message, I think we do really think deeply in our heart.
对，我们每周日来这里敬拜，我们每周五的聚会，当我们回到自己的工作里面的时候，那我们究竟是怎样的一个基督徒？We
come here on Sunday and Fridays, but when we go back to our normal daily life, what Christian are we?
对，我们是只做两天的。 基督徒，还是做一个真正的基督徒？
Are we just two day Christians, Friday and Sunday, or we follow the Lord daily?
对，所以我觉得非常好的信息。然后，其实大家，我有一点想分享的，就是也我觉得今天是个很好的机会，就是。 大家也知道我马上要搬走，因为换工作的缘故。
One thing I want to share is that.
Our family, he is living for New York. So, yeah. Yeah.
While he is trying to have a transition, he also thinks a lot, struggling with many things.
Yeah. 就是我要找这个工作，是让我更加的成功。
更加的有名, 能发更多的文章, 成为更, 更优秀的一个 researcher 或者 professor.
When he tried to find this job, he was thinking, what do I want to do for this new job? Like to get more successful in the research, and to get more famous, and more articles be published.
但是当越这样想的时候, 自己的心里面会越焦虑,
and 越觉得, the more I think this way, the more anxiety I have.
会越觉得没有平安,
less peace I have.
所以当后面有一天, 突然有这个圣灵降临到我的身上, 就是感动我, 就是说, 我要做的这个事情, 就是我现在去找工作, 能不能找到一个其他的工作, 或者我要一直留在ECU, 这都是主为我安排的, 那我接下来所做的一切, 这个工作, not glorify myself, it's glorifying the God.
One day the Holy Spirit told me that regardless if you stay in the ECU or go to the new job, it's for the Lord.
Yeah. 所以这是我的一个分享, 我觉得大家每个人在自己的生命里面, 或者说在当下的这个生活中, 工作中, 也都有自己遇到各样的问题, 可能确实都有自己的 idol, 那我觉得今天信息是对我们一个很好的一个提醒, 我觉得还有时间, 大家可以有什么这个问题, 或者有什么自己的一些分享, 可以,
okay. Yeah. I want to share also that
it wasn't for years,
my brother was close. Yeah, I think similar to what our brother was sharing,